Hypertrophic osteoarthropathy is a syndrome which is associated with the proliferation of skin and the bone. Now, mainly what we see here is the periosteal reaction. The periosteal reaction can be a dense, linear, symmetrical periosteal reaction. It can be exuberant or it can be fluffy or it can be linear type of periosteal reaction. The extent of the disease depends on the duration of the disease. Now, hypertrophic arthropathy usually happens due to some secondary lung disease like bronchogenic carcinoma, lung abscess, etc. But what is very important is to differentiate this from the pachydermoperiostitis, which is a primary syndrome. The involvement of the epiphyseal region, will suggest that it is pachydermoperiostitis, whereas hypertrophic osteoarthritis will be involving the metaphysis and the diaphysis. The most common bones involved in hypertrophic osteoarthropathy are the fibular bone, the tibia, and the ulna. These are the most common bones involved. But involvement of the phalanges can also be seen, but they are less likely to be involved. In this image, we can see some exuberant periosteal reaction both in the tibia and fibula, which is and also even in the femur, we can see some periosteal reactions here, distal end of femur, which is a case of hypertrophic osteoarthropathy. In this image, we can see that the periosteal reaction in the metaphyseal region, we can see the periosteal reaction and subtle periosteal reaction you can see in the phalanges as well. And in the other image, we can see involvement of the radius and ulna, both are showing the periosteal reaction. This is this kind of periosteal reaction, diffuse periosteal reaction, symmetrical periosteal reaction, which can be linear, fluffy, or exuberant kind of periosteal reaction is seen in hypertrophic osteoarthropathy.